Hello friends. So this is the mock test number 2 of Advanced Bank Management, that is called ABM. And this mock test has 20 questions. These 20 questions has been derived from case studies. And you must solve these questions because based on the experience, these questions has been designed. And while solving, you must take maximum time 20 minutes. And in between, I'll be giving the explanation so you can recheck your answers. So here's the first question. First question, they have given some blank is a parameter. Where is the static? Means blank is a parameter. And whereas blank is a static. So you have to tell me which of the following pairs are parameter and static. So before giving the answer, you must know what is parameter and what is static. So parameter is the characteristics of population, because while taking the sample, we have to design, or you can say we have to adopt one population from where you are going to take a sample. So parameter is related to population, whereas static is related to sample. So sample is always smaller than the population. So this is the technique of sampling, and these are the characteristics, means whatever the given here, these are the characteristics. So before you answer, I just show you what is the parameter and what is static. So I have shown here comparison of sample, static and population. Population is written at the third column, you can see here. So population parameter, and here the sample parameter. So when we find out the mean, means mean of population is represented by mu, the symbol only. And mean of sample is static, means what is static of sample is called x bar. Similarly, standard deviation of population is sigma, whereas standard deviation of static is S, and variance sigma square of parameter, population parameter, and S square of the sample. So now I think this concept is clear. So how will you find out? So I'll just give you the hint here. The Greek alphabet, whenever we take the characteristics, Greek alphabet we always give to the population. Whereas for the sample, you can see we have written x bar, we have written s like this. So now you can see what is your answer. So you can see the answer. Sigma s means parameter is always Greek alphabet, sigma s. And here only exception is here that number of terms. So number of terms is parameter capital N and small n. So what is the option correct here? Option is third. Option third means second and third. So option third is correct here. Now see the second question. The dispersion among sample means is less than dispersion among the sample item themselves. Not because. Dispersion among sample. So one thing you have to keep in mind that sample is always smaller than the population. Okay. So dispersion among sample means is less than dispersion among the sampled item themselves, not because. Very large values are averaged down and very small values are averaged up. This is option one. Option two is each sample is smaller than the population from which it is drawn. Number third, the sample items are all drawn from the same population. So one thing you have to keep in mind, very large values are averaged down and very small values are averaged up. Okay, this is not correct at all. Option 2, each sample is smaller than the population, is always correct from which it is drawn. So option 2 is correct. Now see the third. The sampled item are all drawn from the same population. So in a particular problem, or you can say in a particular sampling, all sample items are all drawn from the same population. So option 2nd and 3rd are correct. Now moving ahead. The central limit theorem assures that sampling distribution of the mean. As per central limit theorem, I'll just show you the central limit theorem so that you can understand the concept. So you can see the figure here. That means here two curves are drawn here. Number one curve and number two curve. The big curve, that means which is having more height, it is your sampling distribution, and flat is the population distribution, and this is called your mean. So that means this is the sampling distribution. So how sampling distribution is about the mean, this line is representing the mean. That means mean of the population and mean of the sample are coinciding, where these values will coincide. Now we'll come back to the question once again. So see question once again. The central limit theorem assures that the sampling distribution of the mean is always normal, for large sample size, approaches normality as sample size increases, appears normal only when n is greater than 1000. So one thing you have to keep in mind, as per central limit theorem, the sampling distribution of the mean is always normal for a large sample size. Means if your sample size is large, then it will be normal. Now see the explanation. It is always normal for the large sample size. This concept you have to keep in mind. So in probability theory, the central limit theorem states that the distribution of sample variable approximate a normal distribution, that is bell curve, you might have seen, as the sample size becomes larger. So if your sample size is bigger, that means from a population, if you are taking a sample size bigger, then its distribution will be normal. Means you will get a perpendicular line matching with the population mean. So this you have to keep in mind. Okay, now moving ahead. Question is from the same sampling. In normally distributed population, the sampling distribution of the mean is normally distributed, has a mean equal to the population mean, has a standard deviation equal to the population standard deviation divided by square root of the sample size. So in a normally distributed population, I'll just show you figure once again here. Now see the figure. When sample distribution, that means mean of the sample distribution, is matching with the mean of the population, this line is matching. You can see once again here line. Okay, and when you get the normally, which is the third question, when your sample size is large, okay, and when your sample size is large, in that case, this normal distribution will match with the population distribution. And in that case, whatever options they have given, all will match. That means it is normally distributed, is correct. Has a mean equal to the population mean, is also equal, correct. Standard deviation equal to the population standard deviation divided by square root of the sample size. That means now standard deviation will be equal to the population standard, means population standard divided by square root of n. So this will be standard deviation of sample size. Okay, so this is the formula, that means option third, they have given formula like this. So here all are correct. So what is answer? Answer is option number 4. That means all 1, 2, 3 are correct. So now next. Now this is a different question. The compensation should be adequate, which takes into account the following. Number 1, minimum wages. Yes, correct. Number 2, living wages. Is also correct. Number 3, fair wages. Is also correct. So this is the for the compensation. So all are correct here. 1, 2, 3, option 4 is correct here. Okay. Now, this is a very good question. Consider the following data. Revenue deficit is given 3% of GDP. Grant for capital formation 1.8% of GDP. Primary deficit 1.2%. Non-planned expenditure 1.5%. In the above scenario, effective revenue deficit will be. So you have to find out what is effective revenue deficit. So that means the formula of effective revenue deficit is revenue deficit minus grant for capital formation. So in the above question, revenue deficit is 3% and grant for capital formation is 1.8%. You subtract, you will get the answer 1.2%. So answer is first one is 1.2%. Now, seventh, the future amount of an ordinary annuity of 800 payable at the end of each 3 months for 3 years if the money is worth 8% compounded quarterly. And they have given the value 1.02 to power 12. That means they have made it simplified here so that your calculation is reduced. So here you are going to find out what is the future value of ordinary annuity. So you have must remember what is the formula of future value of ordinary annuity. So it is always cash flow divided by R 1 plus R to power N. So this is the formula of future value of ordinary annuity. And you have to subtract 1 also here. Okay, so this is the future value of ordinary annuity. I'll just reiterate here, C divided by R, 1 plus R to power N minus 1 is the future value of ordinary annuity. What is the present value? Just I'll tell you the formula here because it is coming here. So, present value will be C by R. It is not related to the question, but I'm telling you for your knowledge sake, 1 plus R to power N minus 1 divided by 1 plus R to power N. Okay, this becomes the present value. Okay. And same, if it is not ordinary annuity, annuity due, then you have to multiply 1 plus R in both the questions. Means, future value of annuity due, you have to multiply with the 1 plus R. Here also 1 plus R and in here also 1 plus R. Then it will convert to your future, means future value of annuity due and present value of annuity due. Okay. Now, coming back to the question once again. So, solve this here. I'll just put the value here. You can solve here. So, what is the formula here? C by R 1 plus R to power N minus 1. So, what is cash flow? Cash flow is 800 rupees. 800. And what is rate of interest? Because it is quarterly. So, rate is 8%. So, 8 by 4. Means and divide by 100 also. So 0.02. And here it will come 1 plus 0.2 to power n is how much? 12. Okay, we got 3 years, 3 into 4, 12 minus 1. Now you calculate this. I'll just show you the answer here. You'll get 10,729. Okay, so the answer will be 74 option is correct here. Okay, 10,729 is the answer. Now, question number 8. X and Y recently bought a house. They financed the house with the rupees 1,25,000, very cheap house. 30-year mortgage with a nominal interest rate of 7%. Mortgage payment are made at the end of each month. What is EMI? So, formula of EMI we are going to see here. What is the formula of EMI? Formula of EMI is, I just write the, what is the present value of ordinary annuity. From that you can derive the EMI formula. Okay, so I write here, what is the present value of ordinary annuity? C by R 1 plus R to power N minus 1 divided by 1 plus R to power N. Now, from here you can convert EMI. So, now formula of EMI will be equal to, that means we are going to get the value of C here. So, C will be equal to EMI. That means, whatever present value is there, so P 1 plus R to power N, P 1 plus R to power N, N into R also, because R will come here, and divide by 1 plus R to power N minus 1. So, this is the formula of EMI. Now, put the value. Rate of interest is 7%. So, it will be 0.07. You will get the answer. So, I will just show you formula written here. EMI equal to PR 1 plus R to power N divided by 1 plus R to power N minus 1. So, this is the formula of EMI. Means from the present value of ordinary annuity, you can convert the formula of EMI, and if you calculate everything, you will get 831.63. Okay, so 831.63 is the answer. Okay, so in this question, 831.63. Yeah, so answer is 831. So you can give one option here, 831.63, because option is not given here. Okay, now question number 9th, you can see the question number 9th next. Yeah, which one of the following classification contains division with the label A, B, C1, C2, D and E? So these are divisions related to social grades. Okay, many options are given here. Social class, social economic groupings, social economic classes. So, option is social grade. Okay. Now, next. If the difference between compound interest and simple interest on a certain sum of money for 3 years is 10%, at 10% is rupees 248, find the sum of money. So, here the difference between compound interest and simple interest is given here. What is the formula of compound interest? You have to write here. Compound interest formula is 1 plus R to power N minus 1, and outside you keep the principal. And what is the simple interest? Simple interest formula is P R T by only P R T. Okay. P R T means rate of interest. Now subtract. So P you can take common, 1 plus R to power N minus 1, minus 1 again, and RT. So, this is the value. Okay. So, principal you have to find out, and this value is equal to 248. This is the formula. Okay. This is the formula. Thank you. So I'll read it here. Primary deficit is always equal to fiscal deficit minus interest payments. So primary deficit will be equal to, just I write the formula here, means PD equal to fiscal deficit minus interest payment. Fiscal deficit we got 15,000 in the previous question. Interest payment is 25% of revenue deficit. So revenue deficit is coming from 70,000 minus 50,000, so 20,000. 25% of 20,000 is coming 5,000. So subtract, we'll get the 10,000 here. So 10,000 is the answer. So option 3 is correct. Okay. Now next, in a statewide poll, 103 out of 500 Tamilian rated themselves a die-hard cricket fans. Is cricket fans. Okay, find 90% confidence level for the true population of who were die-hard cricket fans at the time. Okay, here you have to calculate because 90% confidence level. So we have to find out the Z factor. And what is the probability? Probability will be 103 divided by 500. So here the calculation is given here. Okay, so first of all, you have to find out the probability. Probability 103 divided by 500. So we are getting 0.206. And Z score means Z value of Z for 90% confidence level in the first mock test. We have given the value of 90%, 95%, 99%. You must note down this value. So Z factor for 90% confidence level is 1.645. Okay, then what is the formula? Formula is probability plus minus Z factor, and this is the standard error. Okay, so population, I just write the formula, means probability plus minus Z into standard error. So standard error is nothing but square root P1 minus P divided by N. Okay, so I put the value Z 1.645 and P 1 minus P. So P is 0.206, 1 minus P. So you will get 0.794. So multiply, take a square root, you will get approximate value 0.05. I have written here 0.05 and square root of N means 500. Okay, you calculate here. So you will get the value. Means 0.206 plus minus 0.0368. So one time you have to add, other time you have to subtract. Okay. So your answer will be means and 0.2428. Means in the probability, first you have to add, then you subtract. So this is the percentage. Means 16.92% to 24.28% will be die-hard cricket fans. Okay. Now, next question is a very direct question. Additive model for time series. This is a very direct question is there. So, you have to add TSCI. Means you have to add all this value. TSCI you have to add is the answer. Okay. So, option second is correct here. Now, 15th question. The excess of private investment over saving of a country in a particular year was rupees 200 crore. The amount of budget deficit was negative 1500 crores. What is the volume of trade deficit for that country? So we have to see the formula first, then we'll calculate. Okay. So formula of the trade deficit is always M minus X. M minus X means outflow from the country. And X is inflow into the country, direct formula. Or I minus X. I minus S means investment minus inflow into the country. Plus trade deficit, my budget deficit. So whatever budget deficit, my two formula we are having here, M minus X or I minus X plus G minus T. So here value they have given, as per our question they have given, I minus X and G minus T. Okay. But you have to keep in mind that G minus T value they have given negative. Okay, now see question once again here. That means private investment over saving of the country. So private investment over seven of the country, I minus S is given 2000 crore rupees. Amount of budget deficit is negative. Okay, 1500 crore. So you have to add. So your answer is 500 crore rupees. Answer is first is correct. Now question number 16. Question number 16 is direct question. Total expenditure of a government budget is rupees 75,000 crore and total receipt is this. So expenditure is more and receipt is less. So budget deficit is expenditure minus receipt. So answer is 75,000 crore minus 45,000. So answer is correct. Okay. Now 17th question. Arrange the steps in appraisal process. This is the from your human resource management system. Question has been taken. In appraisal process, which is the first one, then second one? Okay. So first one, objective of the performance appraisal, you have to read all there, then you have to arrange properly. Establish job expectation, design in appraisal program, performance management, appraisal performance, performance interview, archive appraisal data, and use appraisal data for appropriate purpose. So this question is already arranged. Okay, objective, establishment, design, performance, appraisal, performance, archive, and use data for the appropriate purpose. So A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H is correct. So option 4 is correct here. Okay, next, handling labor relation and safety laws for company. Labor is a part of, labor is always part of staff function, keep in mind. Okay, so handling labor relationship always part of staff function. Okay, next, in this blank, interview is a type of interview which is pre-planned. The interview which is pre-planned and held in formal atmosphere. So don't go for the wording, means you can say formal atmosphere. The interview which is pre-planned and is held in a formal atmosphere, it is called patterned. Okay, so option 2 is correct here. Now last question of the day. From the following data, calculate the gross national disposable income. Okay, gross national disposable income. National income 2000, net factor income from abroad, consumption of fixed capital, net current transfer from rest of the world, net direct taxes. So here gross income they are asking. Okay, gross income, not net income, don't get confused. So net income you have to add, consumption of fixed deposit you have to add, net current transfer from rest of the world you have to add, and net direct taxes you have to add. So this is the answer here. It means you have to add all this 2200, 150 and 250. You have to add, you will get 2600 crore. So option 4 is correct. So in this way we have concluded our second set of mock test, and you must check your scoring. If your scoring is more than 60, you are in good position. If your scoring is more than 50, still you are good. If it is less than 50%, means you have to work hard. That means if you have correctly answered 10 questions, you are in good position. And if you have answered 12 questions, you are very good. And if you have answered less than 10 questions, that means you have to work hard. You have to revise yourself. Okay. Thank you very much. Have a nice day. And keep watching my next mock test also. Good day.